In today's video, we will be discussing what is quantitative data, types of quantitative data, interval data, and ratio data. Hey champions, if you are interested in these topics, then keep on watching. You can subscribe to our channel for more such videos. In statistics, data can be broadly divided into two parts, qualitative data and quantitative data. We have covered the qualitative data in detail in our last video. If you are interested in the topic, then the link is in the description box. In this video, we will be discussing the quantitative data in detail. So let's get started. Quantitative data talks about quantities, which also means that it is something we can measure in the form of numbers. Since it is represented by numbers, arithmetic operations can be easily performed on it. Being quantities, quantitative data is generally measured using different measuring instruments like weighing machine, ruler, measuring tape, stopwatch, thermometer, etc. Quantitative data is also known as numerical data. For example, weight of the student in a class, temperature in degrees or Fahrenheit, or distance between different cities. Now moving on to the next topic, which is the type of quantitative data. Quantitative data is further divided into two types, interval data and ratio data. First, let's discuss interval data. To understand interval data, let's see its four distinct properties. First, it is measured in the form of numbers. Example, you can easily measure temperature with the help of a thermometer. Second, it has rank and order. Example, while measuring temperature, 1 degree Celsius is always lower than 5 degrees Celsius. Third, it is equidistant, that is, it has equally spaced intervals. Example, the difference between 1 degree and 2 degrees Celsius is the same as the difference between 4 degrees and 5 degrees Celsius. Fourth, the only distinguishing feature of the interval data is that it doesn't have any meaningful zero. Fifth, interval data can be negative. Example, minus 12 degrees Celsius is very much possible. Some examples of the interval data are temperature in Celsius or Fahrenheit, dates, and IQ scale. None of these examples have a meaningful zero. Let us now see what mathematical operations can be performed on it. We can easily group the interval data using equal to and not equal to operators. Sorting is also possible on the interval data. Addition and subtraction can also be done on this type of data. Example, we can say that 2 p.m. is 1 hour later than 1 p.m. However, note that we cannot multiply or divide the interval data as there is no meaningful zero. That is, we can't say that 6 p.m. is twice as late as 3 p.m. Apart from these operations, we can also calculate the central point, which can be mean, median, or mode, range, and the spread of the data, which can be standard deviation or variance. Now moving on to the other type, which is the ratio data. To understand the ratio data, let's see its four distinct properties. It is measured in the form of numbers. Example, you can easily measure distance with the help of any measuring device. Second, it has rank and order. Example, while measuring distances, 2 km is always less than 5 km. Third, it is equidistant, that is, it has equally spaced intervals. Example, the difference between 1 km and 2 km is the same as the difference between 4 km and 5 km. Fourth, the only distinguishing feature of the ratio data is that it has a meaningful zero. Example, you can say that you have traveled 0 km today or have not traveled at all. Fourth, the ratio data can never be negative. Example, there is nothing like minus 5 km in distance. Some examples of the ratio data are distance traveled, age of a person, and weight. All of these examples have a meaningful zero. Let us now see what mathematical operations can be performed on it. We can easily group the ratio data using equal to and not equal to operators. Sorting is also possible on the ratio data. Addition and subtraction can also be done on this type of data. Example, we can say that 3 km is a kilometer far away from 2 km. Here, we can also multiply and divide the ratio data as there is a meaningful zero present. Example, we can say that a 2-year child is half the age of a 4-year child. Apart from these operations, we can also calculate the central point, which can be mean, median, or mode, range, and the spread of data, which can be standard deviation or variance. That's it for today's video. I hope this video cleared all your doubts regarding the quantitative data. You can share your thoughts or questions in the comment box. Subscribe for more such videos. Bye, and meet you in the next one.